With Shadow out of the way, it's time to dive into the top 5 forest heroes and idol heroes in 2021. Note that this video was started before Gloria was released, so I'm not going to include her in my rankings. That said, be sure to drop a comment as to where you think Gloria belongs in this list. Number 5, Elyvia. Elyvia is a pretty underrated hero, even in today's meta. And yeah, honestly, I love her. At 9 and 10 star, Elyvia is a huge upgrade to your PvE damage and survivability with her shrink as well as her fairy guard ability. She is huge for void arc bosses, so she's got a little bit of a buff recently. And honestly, she's not terrible in PvP, although I don't know in the current meta. In some of the older meta, she was honestly sneaky, high B, low A tier sort of hero if you had the right team build around her. I know Chairman ran her for a lot longer than anyone expected to some pretty decent success. But all in all, while the shadow heroes were obviously the cream of the crop, I think the forest heroes are honestly a pretty underrated, and that should be clear with me putting Elyvia as my number 5 forest hero. Oops. So, about to be some weird editing. Number 4 in my forest faction tier list is actually Flora, one of the most underrated heroes in the forest faction. She is incredible as an early game hero, and I highly recommend you check out my Race to E5 series just so you can see what a first E5 Flora can do. As your first E5, Flora can get you to death 1. She can do CLN 20 now with some imprints and support. She has incredible damage in Realms Gate and can get pretty high corruption levels, especially more so than any other E5 heroes. Even after your first E5, she does insane damage in PvE-based game modes. Not as much for Void Arc bosses. You really want to have an Athaqua for that or a Swordflesh Shia. Flora does fall off a bit, especially because Flora, you need to synergize with the Snake since she is going to be doing Poison as her dot, as opposed to Phoenix or even Wolf, who is a little bit better. And in PvP, she is incredibly underrated. Obviously not top tier, but still another one of those sneaky B, A tier heroes. If you want to see someone who hasn't used her in a little while, but has used her in the past, be sure to check out Groovy Styles. I'll try and include a link in the description showing off some Flora PvP. She's really impressive. All in all, a hero with a great kit, and yeah, probably the most underrated forest hero, if not one of the most underrated heroes in the game. She has debuffs, so she's helping keeping your team alive. She's increasing her own attack. I do really want to show her off as an E5 in an Oberon meme team. So if you've seen any of my Guild Wars or just really Brave Trial videos on my main account, you'll see that I've been running a 3 9 stars and a 10 star Oberon. I'd love to get the Florida E5 to run with that team just to show how much damage she can stack with all of those twines and poisons being put out. Number 3, Heart Watcher. Now, this is a little PvE biased, putting her all the way up at number 3, but honestly, she is the only hero that is absolutely required for any PvE type game mode. So not only Flame Shrine and Broken Spaces, but also the Void Arc bosses. The reason for this is Heart Watcher's Mark gives you up to 300% increased damage against the enemy. This is in addition to armor break. This is in addition to any armor reduction. This is in addition to any other sort of debuffs. And yeah, she's obviously you can clear Flame Shrine and Broken Spaces with her even under 150 tickets, but the number of tickets that you can reduce by just having a Heart Watcher on your team, or the number of attacks against a Void Arc boss that you can save just by having a Heart Watcher on your team, is absolutely huge. She's got a decent bit of sustain, and her basic does the Heart Watcher mark, but she really is another master of one trade and jack of no others, similar to Deathsworn. The only reason I have Heart Watcher at 3 when I had Deathsworn at number 5 for Shadow is that Heart Watcher is so good at what she does. And honestly, you don't need to push her past 10 star. If you're pushing Heart Watcher to E3, E4, E5, it's really for silly optimization stuff or Void Arc bosses. And yeah, you're in a sort of whale territory at that point. So the number 2 hero, and this may be a weird transition since I said the order wrong, is going to be Garuda. And if I say number 4 after this, it's because I read the list wrong the first take. Garuda is Not the best Flame Shrine and Broken Spaces damage dealer, but a good one. Garuda is not the best PvP damage dealer, but an okay one. Garuda is pretty passable in Sealand and Aspen Dungeon, especially once you get some imprints into her. And also, now with the new Glory Challenge, you get so many Garuda copies that honestly, new chapters, that it's pretty easy to build Garuda as your first E5 if you so desire nowadays, and she's not the worst at it, still definitely worth building. I wouldn't put her A tier in anything anymore, but Garuda's probably still B tier in everything from Sealand to Tower of Oblivion to Realm's Gate. Not really as much Void Vortex since she's 100% reliant on her active and there are so many carries, but all in all, not a bad hero and still someone I would include on most of my tier lists. Before we slide on over to number 3, I just want to remind you guys to use my BlueStacks link in the description. It's a free installation for Mac as well as PC, and it helps support the channel so that I don't become homeless Doyler. And last but not least, my number 1 forest hero is, if you couldn't figure it out by now, Rogan. Rogan is such a good hero in every game mode. Now that said, before I go any further, to all of you new players, stop building Rogan as your first E5. Rogan is an absolutely terrible first E5. He's not going to get you Death 1. He is not going to get you Sealand 20. Check out the link in the description or at the top to see me try and clear Sealand 20 with 2 E5 Rogans and still struggling with imprints. With that out of the way, Rogan is one of the best heroes in the game and someone you could honestly build to 9-star or 10-star early on and push him up as your 4th, 5th E5 and build a second one later on. When it comes to Flame Shrine and Broken Spaces, as well as Void Arc, Rogan gives your team extra damage and sustain, which are always valuable. His passive is going to give you 20% more crit damage, 20% more attack, and 10% of crit. His passive is going to heal himself, which means he stays alive a little longer. And his active skill gives your heroes Bloodthirsty, which makes them do a ton of extra damage and let them heal themselves. So when it comes to PvE-based game modes, Rogan is a huge buffer. In PvP, not only does he do all of that, he gives your allies speed. So you're going to be outspeeding the enemies. And honestly, I still think, even with the advent of 4Cs, that the best PvP teams are going to still include double Rogan. Probably 3 Transcendence, double Rogan, and a 4th is sort of a flex spot for now. The reason for that is, if you're running double Rogan, you're going to be outspeeding the 4Cs so much that you'll likely kill them before they can even start to sort of scare up those GOAT debuffs on your team. So Rogan has 1,232 base speed, whereas 4Cs only has 1,238, but Rogan's self-buff is going to double on himself since he is an assassin. So a Rogan is going to get 40 speed from another Rogan, including himself, whereas a 4Cs is only going to get 20 speed from their own Rogan. Therefore, the 4Cs team is going to need one Rogan more than the team without a 4Cs. Other than that, yeah, Rogan is just a great support for Realm's Gate and Void Vortex. Check out either of those videos to see a Rogan budget team for Void Vortex. I'm no longer running Rogan on my Realm's Gate team since he's not really optimal compared to like Carry or Amon-Ra in your flex, your 1-2 flex spots, but he's definitely still someone you can bring along. I used to run double Rogan with my Tix in Realm's Gate and was farming Void Corruption 43 pretty easily, running double Ignis, Tix, double Rogan, and Halora. Yeah, honestly, I could wax on about Rogan forever, but I don't want to make this video too long. So after fixing some of my errors with some editing, my top 5 forest heroes for 2021 before the Gloria release are Elyvia number 5, Flora at number 4, Heartwatcher at number 3, Garuda at number 2, and Rogan at number 1. And be sure to click those like and subscribe buttons if you like this video, but let me know in the comments if you disagree with any of my rankings or you'd include an entirely different hero in your list. For more of my beginner guides and tutorials, you can check out this playlist in the top left corner. If you want to watch my Orange Artifact free-to-play tier list, check out this video up here in the top right corner. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons if I've provided you with any value and help me grow this channel.